This tutorial is part of our Building a Python Package course, where we learn how to build, test, and automate deployment of a Python Django middleware package to the Python package index. You can watch the entire course uninterrupted, ad-free, and access updated tutorial source code and other resources from our Udemy course. Now, alternatively, you can access the course via our YouTube playlist. This features tutorials from the course. Links to the YouTube course and YouTube playlist can be found in the video description. In this tutorial, in Django, we're going to learn how to capture SQL queries that have been initiated within our Django application and display that in the terminal. If you're not familiar with SQL, SQL is a structured query language which databases understand. We send SQL statements to a database. The database reads those statements and then performs the actions that we specified in the SQL statement. It's a language for databases. Here in Django, the SQL code is automatically generated for us through the Django ORM. We simply need to provide the model. We need to specify the model manager so we can access the query tools and then specify which query tool we want to use in order to produce a query, which is going to return the resources that we need for this particular view. Here, we're just keeping it simple. So this query, if you like, will just specify the fact we want to grab all the data from the product table. If you haven't seen the previous tutorial, we did populate the database with 100 new records. So we should have now a database and 100 new records inside of that table. So the question might be now, why would I want to capture SQL queries in the terminal? Eventually, you will be working on projects which will have multiple models. These models will have different types of relationships. There are many ways of performing similar actions on your tables. It just happens that sometimes there are different approaches which happen to be more performant, more efficient ways of collecting data from your database. Because there are multiple ways of performing the same action on a database, it would be a good idea to make sure that you are using the correct action or the most performant action to collect data from your database. So being able to see the SQL queries that are actually being performed helps you to diagnose whether you are creating SQL queries which in the most performant way. That is at least one of the many reasons why you might want to view your SQL queries. In addition to that, eventually your application may scale beyond the capabilities of the Django ORM, and you might then start needing to actually create your own SQL queries. So again, being able to view what SQL queries are actually being generated by Django can be very useful in identifying where you potentially need to create some more bespoke queries. Every time our application performs a query in the database, that query will be recorded. So here in Django, we can access that query that has been recorded, and we can then print that to the terminal. So to access that, we can bring in some tools here. So let's just do this in the view to begin with. So from django.db, let's import the connection. So from here, what we can now do is access the query. So we know down here, let me just remove this. We know here that in our view, whenever we run the home page, it's going to run this code, execute this code here. So the first line of this code, we're running a query. We're going to collect all the data from the product table and return it in this variable. So once the database is hit there, and it runs that query, or Django produces that query, we're then going to record that query in the terminal. So we need to add the code below where the query has been performed. And let's go ahead now and just print that out. So what we can do is type print. So we want to print this to the terminal. And what we want to print is the connection dot and then queries. Okay, so let's try that out. So I'll bring up the terminal again. We're going to need to start the application for this. So run server, head over to the web page, So as soon as you open the web page and you run the request for this page, remember that is going to be connected to the URL we created. The URL is connected to the view that we developed, and that's going to then run the code. So if I just drop that down, you can now see that what is returned is nothing. So we are actually returning something here, but the actual, you can see we're printing out the query. We actually didn't return any queries at all. So you might be wondering why that is. Well, first thing, we need to make sure that our application is working in debug true. Normally it is when we're developing, but just double check to make sure that debug equals true, else we cannot view the queries. The second point to remember is that we're only outputting the queries that have been run thus far. And in actual fact, although we are specifying the data that we want to collect from our product table, it doesn't necessarily mean that we're actually initiating this code. Query sets here in Django are considered lazy. So we only want to run them at the exact time that they're needed. So in actual fact here, the code isn't initiated, the query isn't initiated until it's actually called right here. So if I were to now to drop this down below this point here and then run this again, so just make sure you indent that correctly. So let's just bring back the browser. So just go ahead and refresh that page. So I've opened up the terminal now and I can see that I have an SQL query. So at the bottom here, let me just close that and I'll just run the server again. I'll just clear that, sorry. So let me just run the page again. I'm just going to refresh the web page. So I'll quickly refresh this page again, and this time it will be at the top of the terminal. So we can see the result of our query in our code is a select statement. So we say select, and then this then selects all the fields and all the data within those fields from the table that's specified here. So we now have a way of printing out, returning, displaying any queries that our view has generated through the queries that we've defined within our view. In the next tutorial, we'll take a look at how we can better format this into a better looking output to make it easier for us to actually be able to read this SQL statement.